Welcome to the last broadcast of the 1980s Olympics. Today we will be going over all of the events of not only the Olympics this year, but also of the political meaning of this time period. Now, Eric Heldon's 5 gold medals and record for most medals was a big deal, but there was something that was even bigger. The major buzz of this year's Olympics was the men's ice hockey game, and not even the gold round game. The United States upset versus the Soviet Union. The game has won 4-3 and knocked out the reigning champs of the men's hockey Olympics for the last six years of Olympics. We will now cut to an interview of the head coach of the USA hockey team, Herb Brooks. Action.
It was a miracle, but I believe that miracles are earned, and I made every single one of those boys work for our miracle. They earned it, and they deserve to win that game, and then they deserve to win the gold medal, and that they did.
Well said. Well, that was Herb Brooks' point of view of the Miracle on Ice team of the United States.
We will now cut to clips of the USA and Soviet hockey game.
Well, once again, it's Pavlich and Schneider combining. A long shot from a fairly severe angle, catching Tretiak in the top glove side. He's well out, he's in good position, although he was moving a little bit in the opposite direction to where the shot went. Here we can see it again in the top corner. I'm sorry, it's Dean Christen, knowing that there was almost no time on the clock, but the rebound comes right out to Mark Johnson, who goes wide to Tretiak to tie it up. Very careless rebound, an uncharacteristically careless rebound by Tretiak. Should have had very good control of it, but he lost it. There's Stilt. Now watch the puck go to Sterikov. He's in good shape with it, but he loses it right on the Johnson stick and in the net. Here we see it again. Stilt upended, but getting the puck to Sterikov. The rebound to Johnson and in.
U.S. team is depending a little bit too much now on Jim Craig. He's making too many good saves. Here's Ruzioni using the defenseman as a screen. A good low shot. Just the kind of goal that Ruzioni scored about 2 weeks ago against the Soviets in Madison Square Garden. There's Pavukin going down to try to block the shot. It came over to Ramsey. Ilya Letunov gets checked by Ramsey. McClanahan is there. The puck is still loose. 11 seconds. You've got 10 seconds. The countdown going on right now. Borough up to Schultz. 5 seconds left in the game. Do you believe in miracles? Yes!
Well, it definitely was a team effort to beat the Soviets, but a lot of people are taking these Olympics into a more political view of how the U.S. and the Soviets square off in more than just hockey, but in war too. During the games, you could see signs that read, "Get the puck out of Afghanistan," from American fans and others talking about the nuclear weapons buildup, showing how much the United States does not agree with fighting a war somewhere that they don't belong and the weapons race. We will now bring in our expert in the Afghanistan area to talk about the struggle and what's going on with the Soviets in this region of the world.
Go.
Hello, thank you for having me on.
Not a problem. So, Kevin, what exactly is going on with the Soviets in Afghanistan?
Well, the Soviets have invaded Afghanistan, and when they did, they got complete military and political control. Now, they say that it is to stop the Afghanistan civil war and maintain a friendly communist government on its borders. They also say that it will open up better trade with this region, but so far no one has seen this better trade. What other people are saying, including some American officials, is that they took it over to take control over the natural resources, such as natural gas, iron ore, uranium, copper, oil, and some others. This difference in opinions and the arms race between the two countries is making a huge distrust area between the Soviets and the U.S.
Now, I heard that there are other things creating distrust between the Iran and the United States. Do you know anything about that?
Yes, it is about the hostages that the Iranian students took when they attacked the U.S. Embassy. There are 90 hostages, and 66 of them are Americans.
Do you have any idea why they took over the embassy and took these hostages?
Yes, they've made demands that say if they are met, they will release all the hostages.
I'm sorry, but who is this Shah person?
The Shah is an authoritarian ruler of Iran, sort of like a communist. The people do not like his methods, and so they rioted. He then fled to Egypt. After that, the U.S. took him in.
So the Iranian people want us to give up the Shah so they can get technical power over Iran again, or what?
Something like that. Since he's still alive, he technically is still in power. So if he is released and executed or forced to step down, the people could get a new leader or even a new type of government.
Well, that is very interesting. Thank you for coming out.
Thank you for having me.
Now, we are going to an interview of one of the fans that watched the Miracle Game when the U.S. beat the Soviets. Okay, you're good.
Yes, it was.
And what all did you see? What did it feel like to be at the game?
It wasn't like any other sporting event you have ever been to. The excitement of the American fans and the stress of the Soviet ones was unreal. It was unbelievable. You felt like you were part of history in the making. It was one of the most amazing feelings that I have ever experienced.
So, how were the players and the coaches on the bench compared to the fans that were rooting for them?
Well, the coaches were different. The Soviet coach was stressed, like the fans, but Herb, the American coach, was calm up until they had led in the third period. Then he seemed to freak out, and afterwards no one could find him. He had left one of the hallways or something. Now, the players were just like the fans. The whole U.S. bench was going crazy, and the Soviet bench was completely stressed out.
And how were the players after the game?
Well, as expected, the Soviets were furious. They had just suffered one of the first losses in the last six Olympics, and it was to a team that they had completely destroyed early in the year during an exhibition match. The American players were going crazy and looked like they had just won the gold medal. I watched the gold medal game, too, and I would actually say they looked more happy after they beat the Soviets than after they won the gold.
Well, I believe that that is, because they knew that they had just beat the team that was supposed to win the whole thing. And by beating them, they basically won the gold, because no team was equal to the power of the Soviets. Thank you for your time. Back to you, Al.
Thank you, Sierra. Now, as you can see, the hockey game was a major buzz, and it had political meaning as well as pride in the United States. It really shows that we are a great nation and that we have great people. It also shows that we have great work ethic. I hope you enjoyed tonight's broadcast. I'm Albert Michaels, signing off.